So we've had a number of sessions with the cholesterol guidelines and have reiterated many of the principles outlined in the guidelines, that the new guidelines are evidence-based, so only randomized controlled trials were used to produce these new guidelines, that the recommendations appear accurate. The REGARDS study now demonstrates that the risk calculator actually is very accurate for a representative U.S. population. It does overestimate risk in high socioeconomic status Caucasians, physicians, nurses, but it does a good job on the heterogeneous population that the U.S. is now. Increasingly multi-ethnic and all ranges of socioeconomic status. We are pleased to say that we're delighted that ImproveFit was positive, yet it also was a fixed dose randomized controlled trial, so it does not alter our recommendation of fixed dose medication. The revised guidelines very unlikely will reintroduce treatment targets or thresholds until we have a titration trial. And as far as we know, there are no titration trials ongoing. Okay. So these new guidelines, but they're not that new, but we've had a year to chew on them and generate these controversies. They were released in November of 2013. So we've had them now, and we've been able to test them, for example, with this REGARDS. We've also had a number of publications that demonstrate how many more lives will be saved by implementing these guidelines. And we've also had a year to see it applied in practice, see these smartphone apps for the ClinCalc that's very easy for anyone to use, including the patient. Once they have their cholesterol levels. I think it's critically important. People, they may not even be our patients, can walk into Walgreens now and get a complete risk assessment because they can get their finger stick cholesterol by the same pharmacist that might give them a flu shot. They can have their blood pressure measured. They could calculate their own risk. Many of our patient subjects now have the Fitbits, they have the Jawbones, they have many digital technology devices that are helping them manage their own health. So I think it's an exciting time. Well, as it turns out, the latest CDC data that came out maybe 12 months ago showed that we had plateaued. And that our children actually had become slightly less obese. And that probably is a reflection of doing a better job of not having these vending machines filled with candy, soda, and chips. So we think we are winning a few battles in the obesity area. That said, you know, obesity is not a major risk factor for cardiovascular disease. And we've seen the obesity epidemic and the diabetic epidemic occur in the face of steep declines in cardiovascular disease, morbidity, and mortality. I'm not saying it's good to be obese. I'm just saying it may not be the target that many people would like to target. And I think we can do a good job with tools that we already know work. For example, implementing the cholesterol guidelines with statin lipid-lowering therapy, we could save probably 400,000 lives if we take the NHANES data and we just apply these guidelines. Well, a lot of lives would be saved.